I'm David Auschlo. Welcome. I'm the director of the Chicago Quantum Exchange, and it's my great pleasure to open the 2025 Chicago Quantum Summit by welcoming Illinois Governor J.B. Pritzker to the stage to start us off.
Well, that is the briefest introduction I've ever received. Thank you very much, David. In order to avoid any politics, it was just, here he is. It is great to see everyone this morning. Good morning. What a great pleasure it is to welcome you all to the 8th annual Chicago Quantum Summit. It's a pleasure for me to be the host governor of this august gathering. And first, I want to thank the summit organizers, the Chicago Quantum Exchange, most especially David, whose work has been vital to our becoming really a worldwide hub for quantum technology. And of course, Kate Timmerman, the CEO of CQE. And I also want to express my gratitude to the University of Chicago's president, Paul Olivisados, and the many partners who are here today, who not only made this summit possible, but have driven the progress that has been made in this industry really for the last two decades. I think of the quantum industry as kind of a 15-year overnight success. I'm sure some of you have been doing this for longer than 15 years, but the point, of course, is that it's only just recently received, I think, the attention that it has deserved for quite some time. And as we gather this year, there's really an extraordinary transformation happening here in the heart of America, one that will shape the future of computing, the future of communication, and scientific discovery for generations to come. And of course, I'm talking about how Chicago has become one of the world's leading hubs of quantum technology in the United States. In previous paradigm shifts that have taken place, we've seen the emergence of technology hubs in Silicon Valley, of course, in Boston's Route 128 and elsewhere. But the quantum revolution is being written in different places. It's especially happening here along the shores of Lake Michigan in the laboratories and startups of Chicagoland. It's the result of deliberate choices, of strategic investments, and of a unique convergence of resources. The foundation that already exists is, of course, in our world-class research institutions. Chicago boasts an unparalleled concentration of quantum expertise. The University of Chicago, it's, of course, the atomic age was born here underneath the football field, no longer used as a football field, right, President Olivisados? Nevertheless, great things have come from that football field. And of course, it gave birth to the Chicago Quantum Exchange and is now a leader in quantum information science. And just down the road, Argonne National Laboratory operates some of the most sophisticated quantum research facilities in the world, and last week announced a partnership with NVIDIA and Oracle to build the largest AI supercomputer for scientific discovery. Northwestern University brings additional strength in materials science and quantum engineering. Fermilab has become a major player in quantum networking and sensing. And the University of Illinois' Granger School of Engineering is graduating the next generation of our quantum workforce. But research institutions alone, I think you all know, don't by themselves make a successful hub. The Chicago Quantum Exchange, launched in 2017, is at the center of a collaborative ecosystem that is still building and is already great, but so much more to do. And it brings together universities, national laboratories, industry partners in a way that simply doesn't exist in most other places. It's not just about proximity, of course. It's about intentional cooperation. It's about the scientists from global institutions working together on shared problems, sharing equipment worth hundreds of millions of dollars, training the next generation of quantum engineers as a unified community. Two of the nation's five federally funded National Quantum Information Science Research Centers are right here in Illinois. We have the QNX Center, headquartered at Argonne, that focuses on quantum communication and sensing. And finally, one thing that really sets Chicago apart is the Illinois Quantum and Microelectronics Park. It's a purpose-built ecosystem designed to take quantum technologies from lab bench to market. This development is attracting quantum computing companies, startups, established tech giants, DARPA, and the federal government who want to be where the action is. Chicago also features infrastructure advantages that really are significant. Chicago sits at the crossroads of America's fiber optic networks, making it ideal for quantum communication research. Illinois has more nuclear baseload energy than any other state in the United States, which matters enormously when you're running, dilution refrigerators that cool quantum processors to near absolute zero. Plus, the cost of living and doing business here is lower than in coastal tech hubs, which means that research dollars go farther, startups can stretch their runway, and quantum experts moving here from around the world can live more affordably. And let's not forget talent. Chicago's and Illinois' universities graduate thousands of STEM students every single year, and the city attracts thousands more from schools across the Midwest, Purdue, UW-Madison, University of Michigan, and elsewhere across the Midwest. The engineers that we need are coming here naturally and have for many, many years. That's on top of the deep bench of engineering talent from our traditional industries here, many of whom are retraining for quantum careers. The economic impact is already visible. IBM established a quantum computing facility and announced its new National Quantum Algorithm Center in Chicago. Quantum computing startups and more established quantum players have announced Chicago as their headquarters city. The supply chain is developing here. Companies making specialized cryogenic equipment, precision lasers, quantum-grade materials are setting up shop here or are already here and turning their businesses in that direction. We're not just talking about a few labs. We're talking about an entire industrial ecosystem emerging around quantum technology. There's also something fitting about Chicago's quantum ascendancy. This is a city that prides itself on its big shoulders, on doing hard things well, on making the impossible possible. Quantum technology isn't easy. It's arguably the most difficult technology humans have ever attempted to master. And it requires patience and persistence and collaboration. And those are Chicago values. So we're building something that's really hard to replicate. It's a complete ecosystem where fundamental research, applied development, commercial deployment happen all in the same place, supported by shared infrastructure and sustained federal and state investment. The foundation of our quantum future is laid. The momentum, honestly, is undeniable, and the opportunity before us is truly extraordinary. Now, I wouldn't be doing my job if I left here without inviting you all to join us here, not just today, but more permanently. So all of you, wherever you may be from, in the United States, in Australia, in Europe, or elsewhere, I want you to know that Illinois is the absolute best state to live, work, and raise a family, and to build a business. And I'm your concierge. I will show up at your door with a basket when you move here. But our quantum future really is being built right here, and we welcome you to the city of Chicago and the state of Illinois. Thank you all very much.